Welcome back to We're Not Really Here, and it is half time in the Women's FA Cup final live from Wembley, and the score so far is 1-0 to Manchester City. Kyle and I have been watching here from the Etihad Stadium, which is always a little bit strange. We're at an empty Etihad watching an empty Wembley, but we're very happy right now.
Of course, Manchester City going into half time 1-0 up, the Tower of Power, as the US Soccer Women's National Team are tweeting, Sam Mewis after she rose above absolutely everybody else, got that header, a powerful header into the back of the net after an Alex Greenwood cross. And I mean, this is the position that Gareth Taylor wanted to go into at half time. Driving seat, you're at Wembley, you're in the Women's FA Cup final. This is it. You've just got 45 minutes and then there you are. You've got yourself a trophy from last season in this season, the first of two, hopefully.
I absolutely love that, Kyle. The Tower of Power. That is amazing, because she is a tower. I remember watching in the first game, seeing her play live and just thinking she is so much taller than everybody else. And Sam Mewis is 6 foot tall. And I was like, Kyle, how tall are you? And Kyle is 6'3". So we get an idea of just how tall she is. So no wonder when that corner came in that Sam Mewis was able to get up above everybody, although probably with a little bit more space than Everton would have liked, and get that bullet header on it. So as a tall person, Kyle, that really helps, doesn't it?
It does. Yeah, 6'3". It's great if you can jump up and head the ball. I can't. So even though I'm 3 inches taller than Sam Mewis, she can head the ball a lot better than me. That's why she's out on the pitch and I'm sat here in the studio. So I just think that what a cross it was. But Manchester City women's team, they've been dominant throughout. I mean, possession-wise, the chances they've created. Ellie Roebuck's not really had much to do in the sticks for Manchester City. So I think that this is a great position to be in. We saw as the players were coming off the pitch that that Willie Kirk was he was talking to Izzy Christensen, and obviously she's been an integral part for Manchester City before. She'll know this team, but he was actually just speaking to her and saying, we need to probably do something. So Everton have got everything to do, whereas Manchester City women's team, they're in the driving seat. As we said, they're in third gear right now. We'll come out, we'll step it, put it into fourth, and we'll get the win.
And of course, absolutely dominant in possession, which is something that we say no matter which Manchester City team is playing, whether it's the youth teams, the men's teams, the women's teams. We're looking at about 75% possession in that first half. We had to be patient, obviously, for the first goal to come. But like Kyle said, an absolutely incredible corner from Alex Greenwood, who had been whipping a few in up to that point. And Sam Mewis, of course, was able to get above that and get the goal there. Something that we should highlight for the second half is, of course, Lucy Bronze did pick up a yellow card in the first half for one of her challenges. So that is something maybe slightly nervous for the second half, Cal.
Yeah, maybe, but I think that Lucy Bronze, we know that she's one of, if not the best player in the world. And actually, you're looking at her and the position that she plays. You're going to pick up yellow cards, but she's a professional. She knows exactly what she's doing. She'll just know that she can't fly into a few challenges now. But it's probably better being 1-0 up and being on a yellow card than drawing or losing, because you might lose a bit more focus then, whereas they have to remain focused now. And like I said, she is a professional. She's been there. She's been in some of the biggest competitions in the world. She's won the biggest trophies as well, and she'll know exactly how to handle that in the second half.
And going into that second half now, 1-0 up, you know, we've been dominating possession. Chloe Kelly, you know, for me, down the right-hand side, she's been absolutely dominant down that right-hand side. But like you say, players like Lucy Bronze, with the experience they've got, with the trophies that they've won, obviously other players that we've got on the pitch, you know, Sam Mewis, Roosevelt, Steph Horton, the experience that we've got, how much and how important is that now going into the second half, you know, on just, you know, 1-0 at this point, the experience that we've got in the team that can now drive this home?
I mean, Manchester City women's team, they've been dominant throughout. We've seen them win the WSL. We've seen them win trophies at times as well. We've seen them do so many different things over the years. And actually, when you put that into perspective and you think, wow, they've been there, they've done that, they've got the T-shirt, they've won the trophies, they've got the medals in the cabinets at home, and going into this second 45, that is it, the experience and the wealth of experience that they've all got. They've been there for seasons. They've won the trophies. They've won the FA Cup. The current holders, they know what it takes to win this trophy. So I think that experience will definitely help moving forward. It's a big 45 minutes, but if it's one team that you think can control it, it's Manchester City women's team.
And we are hearing as well from our insiders down at Wembley that Everton summer signing is limping on the side just now. And her name is just gone. Valerie Govan. She's limping on the side of the Wembley pitch at the minute. So we'll let you know if there's going to be any substitutions there at halftime.
We will indeed. Right, we're building a name for ourselves as a club where big name talent want to come and play and train with Manchester City. And we've got the facilities, we've got the coaches, and we've got a winning mentality, as you've seen from that first half right there. So that is why just a few seasons ago, our American superstar Carly Lloyd spent some time at the club, and our American producer Ariel Costello caught up with Carly this week just to see what she thinks about the FA Cup ahead of this final today.
Thanks, Natalie. Over here on this side of the Atlantic, all U.S. women's national team fan eyes are on Rose Lavelle and Sam Mewis as they prepare for their first trophy final with Manchester City Women. Now, they are not the only U.S. women's national team stars to have featured for City. So earlier this week, I was lucky enough to catch up with Carly Lloyd, a legend of the American game, about her time at Manchester City, playing in an FA Cup final herself and scoring at Wembley. Here's what she had to say.
Having played there for the 2012 Olympic final was unbelievable. And I remember winning gold there with my teammates and looking around the stadium and seeing 83,000 people there. And it was amazing. I never thought that I'd have the chance or the opportunity to play in that stadium again. And to then go back several years later and be able to play in such a prestigious tournament as well, like the FA Cup, and then win it is pretty cool. You know, my name along with the rest of my teammates during that time is going to be etched in history.
For this season of the FAWSL, we've been really excited to welcome two of your U.S. Women's National Team teammates who played with you when you won the World Cup in 2019. What kind of conversations did you have with them before they chose to make the leap? What kind of advice did you give them?
You know, I remember them asking me, many people asking me just, you know, when I went over to Manchester City the following year, what I thought of it, how it was. And I was completely honest. I said, it was amazing. The players were all welcoming. Everybody was amazing at the organization. It was the most top-notch club I've ever been a part of. And that on the women's side is something that you want to play for. You know, really happy for both of them. I think that, you know, they're two aspiring players who are unbelievable players. They have talent and you know, they want to just continue to better their game. So I was really happy for them. I thought there was no better place to go than City. I'm a little biased in that regard. You know, I've checked in with Sam here and there, and I think, you know, she's obviously doing really well. I've got to check in with Rose and see how she's doing. Hopefully she's continuing her ice baths now that she's not around me.
Could we get a good luck message from you to our squad for the Women's FA Cup final?
Yes. So I just want to wish you all the best of luck. I'm not a huge good luck person. I believe that you create your own luck. And I know you guys are going to do fantastic. I'm with you. I'm obviously biased. I'm obviously rooting for you. So go get it done. Lift that trophy and be proud and just be there for one another and give it all you've got.
Thank you so much for your time, Carly. It's been an honor and a pleasure.
Ariel Costello there, catching up with American superstar Carly Lloyd. And I don't know, Ariel must have thought you were throwing to her there because she said thank you to you.
My name's Natalie now.
Yeah. One thing that she just said there, Carly Lloyd, which I think is the work ethic, and actually it's that personality of a winner. You don't have luck. You're not lucky. You create your own luck. And that's what this team are doing on that pitch. 45 minutes gone. Sam Mewis, she rose up above everybody else. She got her FA Cup debut goal against Arsenal in the semi-final. She's got that second one there as well. They're not lucky. They're creating their own luck, Nat.
Absolutely love that. As soon as she said that, I was like, yes, that is a message for all of the young footballers out there. You make your own luck. Work hard. And we've certainly been working hard today, you know, dominating that first half in possession. What I also loved what she said as well is the praise that she had for the club, you know, for a player that has basically won everything, you know, FIFA World Player of the Year, you know, Olympics, pretty much anything that a female footballer can win, that woman has won. And she is praising City, for her experience here and just saying how highly she is of it. I mean, that is an incredible reference.
It is indeed. And we've got a big 45 minutes coming up here as Manchester City women's team take on Everton in the FA Cup final. And we can see Wembley right here looking beautiful in all its glory with the banners up saying we're Man City. A huge 45 minutes to go. Manchester City in that driving seat. It's 1-0 and we'll be back at full time, hopefully, to see the winners, Manchester City, of the FA Cup. And we'll see you then.